for the Hoyas as they beat Denver 13-6.
We flew to the nation's capital to capture the Georgetown Hoyas, a team that has the players, won the Big East 5 consecutive years in a row, but can't seem to get over the hump to the Final Four. I got access to capture the Georgetown men's lacrosse team for 48 hours. Can the Hoyas make it to championship weekend? We find out in the end of this video.
You got the nod to come here. What was that feeling like for you?
It was crazy. My daughter Campbell was born 3 weeks earlier, so we had a new baby. Fortunate enough to get the job here. And nobody ever tells you, but as soon as you get that job, you know, you hear from coaches, you go through the interview process. And when I was lucky enough to be hired, it's like, okay, go figure it out. And then you're like, oh boy, here we go. And just kind of leaned on past experiences to get me going for that first year and figure out how we wanted to do the things here that we're achieving now.
Exciting, I think is the first thing that comes to mind. I had known Coach Shriver since I was probably a freshman in high school. You know, an exciting opportunity, I think, to join a program where I think, you know, the people you're gonna be surrounded by are the most important thing to me, no matter what you're gonna do. And knowing him and how special his experience has been here as a player and as a coach, and the ability to join him as a friend and now be able to work with him every day is something that I was really, really excited about. And then obviously the success that Georgetown has had on the field, you know, before I got here, just to be a part of something like that, closer to home, a city where, you know, I knew a variety of people here already, just from a variety of aspects. It was really exciting, both from a job standpoint, but from a personal standpoint as well.
Why did you decide to come back?
It was honestly a pretty easy decision. The guys below me, the three classes below me, over the past 3-4 years, I mean, I've just gotten so close with them. They made this so easy for me. If I could get one more year to play lacrosse and hang out with some of my best friends, it's a no-brainer.
What's the mindset going into 2024?
To prove people wrong, I think. I think it's very easy to buy into a narrative of we lost a lot of guys, and obviously incredible players from Will Bowen, Tucker Dordovic.
And there's going to be a lot of names that people haven't seen, and people are going to underestimate us. And I think that's the best thing, because I think we're going to surprise a lot of people.
I think the mindset is unselfishness. I think that's going to be the identity for this group. We had some stars last year and the last few years. I think we're going to have to rely on each other like we never have before. And it's an exciting opportunity. But I think that if we can be unselfish, we can do all those little things right, I think we'll be successful.
From the product they put out on the field, it all starts in the classroom. Georgetown being one of the smartest schools in the nation, grades are everything. Let's take a deep dive into the classroom.
What's up guys, Luke Schlank, sophomore here, number 31, and I'm from Greenwich, Connecticut.
Henry Caponiti, I'm a sophomore as well, number 41, and I'm from Rye, New York.
What's up, Holt Mathias, junior, from Darien, Connecticut. I play attack and I'm number 11.
We're gonna be taking you guys on a little Georgetown campus tour.
All right, so this is the first stop of the day. We got Hoya snacks, so a lot of guys like to come here after practice. They have like a 3:30 class. There's protein shakes, waters.
He likes Capo to get some of those. Comes, gets his Twinkies before every practice, so.
He's putting you down.
All right, next stop is the Healy Family Student Center. Great spot to study. They got a coffee shop in here if you ever need a study break, and it's a good view, so let's get ahead in there.
All right, first stop here, we got Hill Toss. It's a great little spot, especially if you want to impress a lady friend. I myself, you know, I have a girlfriend, so, you know, we spent a lot of quality time in here. Great vibe. You got avocado toast and different kind of pastries and croissants and whatnot, but some overnight oats. Guys are really big on the overnight oats here, so especially Joe Caesar. Yeah, great little spot.
All right, guys, this is the study center. Come here, get a lot of work done. I don't know if Capo's ever been in here before because he's not doing too much work. But, you know, us other students coming here, try to get some work done, get good grades, high GPA to please the coaches.
Yeah, and if we want to show you as well, this little outdoor terrace here. Number 41, Henry Caponiti, likes to bring his foot ladder out here and, you know, get some footwork in, a little study break. He likes a little turf, a little COD for the kid, but.
COD, yeah. Some homework, and a view.
Exactly.
How could a recruit not want to come here?
I don't know.
That's a good question. Everybody has their own choices. Everybody has their own opinions of things. But I think what you see is what you get when you come here. And you're going to spend so much time here, but not so much with the coaches. You're going to spend a lot of time in the locker room. You're going to be around those guys. And that's really, really important. I think those are the things that has allowed us to have some success over the past couple of years.
You know, everything that you need as a lacrosse player, I think we have. Again, high academics, all that good stuff. I think, you know, one of the reasons maybe, you know, and not on us. And, you know, I think the lacrosse world, you know, certainly looks at certain schools, you know, whether they be schools in the ACC, Big Ten, Ivy League. They look down upon schools that aren't in those conferences. It's just a personal opinion. Conversely, I think arguing against that, you know, again, we play a national schedule. We play teams in those leagues. You know, we've been fortunate these last few years to be in the NCAA tournament. So I think that's a big thing.
I don't see why they wouldn't. I mean, you have, it's the nation's capital. You know, you can just a quick walk down to the monument to the White House, and we have all the amenities here. And, you know I made the right choice, and I don't see myself anywhere else. So, you know, I love being part of this Georgetown family.
Not many long walks, nothing more than 7 minutes. Capital can't really handle much other than that, but.
Yeah, so these are the exorcist steps.
What are the exorcist steps?
The exorcist steps are just a set of stairs right outside campus, and they were a main feature of the first Exorcist movie.
Good old fashioned set of steep stairs we use for various reasons, whatever it may be.
A bear to run up, I'll tell you that.
So it's the last stretch of our Remo run. It's a 3 mile run the team has to complete before Thanksgiving. And the last leg is you run all the way up the Exorcist steps and then finish at the front gate. So we definitely see those more than we would like.
Yeah, we run these a ton. Bunch of like iconic Coach Warren phrases definitely come from here. Obviously are very steep and they're not fun to definitely run up and down, but you know, it's a discipline. This is the main gates of Georgetown. As you can see, we got Healy Hall, Copley Hall, White Gravener. You know, that's a dorm. This is the first ever building that was built at Georgetown. So it's just kind of like that iconic building every time.
I mean, if you look kind of just out here, this is where a bunch of like townhouses and apartments are. It's kind of just like the main center point where you sort of just meet. And it's, yeah, like Holt said, it's just a very famous spot. This is the John Carroll statue. He's the founder of Georgetown, 1789. He was the first Archbishop of Baltimore as well. I personally like to refer to him as the Big John.
he's just a legend.
So this is Healy Hall. Come right through the front gates. You get a beautiful look at this building.
So before we go inside, it's an old Georgetown myth. You know, if you step on this Georgetown logo here, you don't graduate.
Capital didn't step on it, but he still might not graduate.
What's up, boys? I'm JoJo Dean. I'm number 15. Today I have business statistics class, and I'm going to take you guys through it.
So this is the bioethics library. It's like a Harry Potter looking library. It's another big staple of Georgetown. I spent a lot of time here as well.
You the smartest guy on the team?
Oh, no shot. Gotta give a special shout out to Cade Caggiano, fellow Italian, my dad. He's the brains of this team, and I try to, you know, latch off his success. So. So these are the famous Old North steps. A lot of presidents like to give speeches here. As you can kind of see over on the wall, you got all the lists. The guys that came here, you got GW up there, you got Barack Obama.
One day, right here, Henry Caponiti will be coming back here to give a speech.
Yeah, I mean, people do say I have a lot of similarities with these guys, but I don't like to brag right now.
The Georgetown bookstore. A lot of guys get their textbooks upstairs. There's a really good coffee shop upstairs called Uncommon Grounds. Get you out of the Ohio State red, maybe. Get you a little, get you a little Navy Georgetown.
Who's the best dressed on the team?
As of recently, JoJo Dean, or maybe Cade Caggiano. He's always got like the Tommy jeans, like medium tees, rocking the guns out. So this is the faculty club restaurant. Every Friday or Saturday before a game, we come have a team meal here. Great food. A lot of the guys, you know, we come in, it's a buffet style. Get pretty pumped up as Coach Warren, like the day before practice, like gets all the boys juiced up to come to the faculty club, so.
Coach Warren always comes in here with his new pair of Jordans, shows them off to the team, so it's good to see what he has lined up for game day.
Do you think Coach Warren is the funniest Division I coach?
I think he's got to be.
Yeah, I mean, he's got a huge personality that's tough not to notice. He found out pretty early that he wanted to be himself.
I don't know, funny looking, definitely. I look like a combination of Shrek and Brett Favre.
If you're hanging out with him just in the office, it's just all jokes, funny, you know, making sure that relationship's there. He still is so in touch, which is hard to do with a college kid's perspective, a younger kid's perspective, and all those jokes and what's funny to them. And then you get on the field, he flips a switch, and he's just like any other D1 coach that's getting after you. So it's unique in his ability to do that, but he's hilarious. His jokes are still really funny.
Undoubtedly. He's got no problem just throwing out one-liners, whatever it is. He's going to be there to just put a smile on your face, and it's really cool to be able to experience that every day.
Give me your best Coach Warren one-liner.
His go-to is just, what are we doing? What are we doing out here?
What are you doing?
Hammer.
He loves that one.
We were struggling to shoot last year, and Coach Hogan started bringing up hammering the ball to the pipes, and Coach Warren just ran with it and just started, would be up here in the middle of the film room, or would check in on the O-film or whatever we were doing. He'd just be like, hammer, and it's just awesome. He keeps it light.
Before pregame, gives like these money pregame speeches, gets in the huddle, yells at us. Last thing he says, let him know. And he breaks the huddle, and that's when we take the field. Yeah.
Also one of the scariest. Sometimes like when he's yelling and the spits all over the place, like it's a little terrifying. You gotta put your poncho on and get out of the splash zone before he gets all over you. But yeah, makes me love the game way more. Just a really just awesome presence to be around as he's helping us through, you know, the early ages of our career, not only in lacrosse, but in like life as well. So just want to give a little shout out to girls lacrosse.
Who's your favorite girls lacrosse player?
I would have to say probably my girlfriend, number 23, Leanna Sahalis. But yes, if I were to choose my non-girlfriend, probably give it to number 3, Kendall Steer, who's waving her stick at us right now. What's up, Kenny?
The past couple years, this team's been on the doorstep. Quarterfinal loss, first round loss, quarterfinal loss, first round loss. Why can't Georgetown make it to the Final Four?
Probably my fault. It comes on me. You look back and you learn. You try not to make the same mistake twice. For us, you learn from failure. You know, in order for us to move forward, learn from those failures. So when they pop up again, or those situations or scenarios pop up again, guess what? You might be in a different position next time.
Obviously, the goal is for us to get back to the Final Four. You know, our program's only had one appearance back in 1999, never been in the national championship game. I think that is the goal, but a lot goes into it, and I think anything in life, right, the last step, kind of the breakthrough step, is always seems to be the hardest and the steepest, and that's kind of what we've been fighting these last few years, and we're going to continue to just fight.
This program has been up and coming for the past 5 years. Of course, we've won 5 conference titles, but taking that next step is a pretty big leap. No, that's one of the main things that I wanted in a college, was something that hadn't been done before, and something that, you know, I want to do this year and I plan to do this year.
Every team approaches it differently. I think we've run into some really strong teams, but I think going forward, it's just understanding we've learned from our failures and understanding how we can attack those, never get complacent, and just look forward.
We didn't have enough reps with each other. You know, it's hard to build that stuff. Some of these teams that are winning down the stretch have years of experience playing late in May with each other. I think we're just kind of cracking that. But yeah, I've been really impressed with this year's team to come back after a tough loss in the quarterfinals and completely wash that, forget about that, and just think about how we can kind of get better to eventually make it to the Final Four.
What's up, guys? I'm Jordan Ray, number 45 from Carroll County, Maryland, and this is the Thompson Athletic Center.
All right, so coming in here, we got the legend. We got to talk about him first. You know much about him?
Yeah, legendary basketball coach. He actually was one of the first African-American coaches to lead an NCAA team to a national championship, which is pretty cool.
Oh, we got a statue of him right here.
Yep.
Is this actual size?
He's actually this tall.
Holy shit.
Legendary. Just coming in here, going down to the locker room. We have some rooms upstairs, so we'll do study hall up there. Our weight room's actually right around the corner too, so okay. It's pretty nice.
So you guys won this past spring. Who'd you guys beat?
We beat Denver in the championship.
Okay, and what was that game like?
Oh, it was an awesome game. It was a good win for sure.
Okay, all right, sweet. Weight room's down this way. So what was the tradition with you guys banging on the doors beforehand?
It's a good time.
So yeah, this is the weight room here. here about 3 times a week, lift, do whatever, work on mobility, recover in here, all that, the whole thing.
Looks like you guys are about to hit a lift yourself in this outfit. I like it. What are the lifts usually like in here, you know, with the juice? Is everyone going crazy?
Yeah. They're crazy. Right from the start, we come in here, super high energy lifts. And one thing we know we control every day is our effort and energy. And that's one of our pillars of the team. So we try and just bring that all throughout the lift and then right out to practice.
Who's the guy on the team that like probably needs to be living in here?
Holt Mathias.
Really?
Holt Mathias, 100%.
So this is the nutrition center, you know, after lifts. You come in here, grab some protein bars. Yeah, she got meal exchanges here. So if you got
class,
write down if you need a meal quick, you come in here after practice or lift and then go to class, you can eat it on the go. So,
really?
Yeah.
They also have like a high protein, high carb, like whatever type of meal plan you're looking for, they have that all in here. So just come in, you sign up the week before, you come in, grab your box, and then just head on back with your day.
That's dope. All right, perfect.
Yeah. Right here, these are the loops. Every day after practice, after you shower, you just throw on your clothes on a loop, throw it in here, throw your towel in here, and then you come back down here, and they wash your clothes the next day. So I'll show you mine.
Wow.
I brought my stuff back already. So.
Wow, that's sweet. Just... And then we're hopping into your locker room now.
We're with Tuck. This is still standing.
Yeah, what was the infamous Tuck story? How did he not know what got him in?
I honestly don't know. I mean, he's got a sense of humor where, like, sometimes you can't tell if he's joking or not, but GATA stands for get after their asses.
Not what he said in the video.
Yeah, exactly, exactly.
What is GATA?
Get after their asses.
Get after their asses is just the mantra of the program, how we want to conduct ourselves pretty much on and off the field.
That's a phrase coined by legendary coach, Coach Urich. Basically brought Georgetown lacrosse to where it is today.
And literally it means kind of get after their asses, right? The idea of like if you're competing against somebody, you want to compete and get after them.
It's certainly something that has been in the program since Coach Urich brought it with him from Hobart. And it means something to every team. And I think it's really important that each team finds its own way to represent that phrase or acronym, so to speak.
Really take to heart like the little details of things or the toughness of things, the hustle behind every single play and not taking things for granted. So it's something that these guys really take to heart and just enjoying being around with each other every day and the energy behind it is something special.
This is where you guys spend majority of your time. What does this place mean to you guys?
It's like a second home, honestly. You're in here all the time with like 50 of your best friends just getting after it on the field, off the field.
We definitely have a standard for our locker. As you can see, you know, we have the helmet here, the gloves are up here, thumbs up, cleats back there, arm pads, shoulder pads, and our sticks are lined up like that. And then under my cubby, I kind of got some clothes and shoes there.
Yeah. We got the couches over here. Obviously, post-practice, you guys can hang out, chill out. Who's on the couches the most? Who's just like a locker room?
Leary's always posted on the couches. Yeah.
Really? I like that.
He just sits there sipping on his chocolate milk, eating his goldfish out here. And then before games, too, he'll get Wawa, so he'll be in there early just eating his Wawa.
Just chilling.
Yeah, just chilling.
I like always. That. And then who's usually on aux?
Leary in the mornings, and then Moot, Seamus Foley is on it, too.
Who's the guy on the team that you would kind of get worried if he was on aux? You don't even know what he's going to play.
Luke Schlenk. So this is the film room we're in every day.
One of my favorite things I got to see live today was, I don't even know what it's called, you guys basically just tackle everybody.
We have QC, it's basically attendance. He normally reads off all our names, make sure we're all here, and then Seamus Foley will go one clap, we'll all clap, and then Coach Warren, whatever day it is, we'll see it. Today, it's Wednesday, it'll be like, it's Wednesday, and then everybody will just go crazy and
that's
just
so
like, tackle each other.
One clap, ready? Yeah.
And where do you guys sit? Are you guys getting in the middle of that mosh pit or are you guys on the outside?
Yeah, so they do it by class typically. So got like seniors, juniors, sophomores. My class is in here. Freshmen are up top.
Where's the best spot to be? Is it like up here to be able to like run up the stairs and go tackle somebody up top?
Nicky Solomon sat like right here and every day he would just run all the way up to the top and just tackle Luke Schlenk every day. It was so fun.
I love that.
Zach Hirsch, what does he mean to this program?
He is a legend.
Zach Hirsch, I love that kid so much.
Zach Hirsch is an awesome teammate of ours, number 52.
So Zach Hirsch is our Team Impact teammate. So we signed him last year, and there's a crew of Team Impact kids. So Team Impact is an organization that partners kids with disabilities and illnesses with strong college role models and college sports programs. He's kind of like, every time he comes to practice, he's the happiest guy out there. So it's kind of fun to have him around.
It's been a lot of fun for us. I think our guys have done a great job with that. And we love the Hirsch family. They're family of ours now.
I mean, he just means so much to this program. You might have like a bad day, and then that kid shows up to a game or a practice and he's sporting his big smile. And it turns you around. It's one of the best things that I've ever been a part of in my entire life.
He means everything to us. I think the coolest thing about Zach, and honestly his brother Josh too, who's a big part of it as well, just a great kind of smile to have there, and they don't care if you make a good play, bad play, and Zach's just sitting there waiting to give you a hug. So it gives you great perspective. It's awesome to have that. We hope we've had a good impact on them, because they've certainly had fantastic impact on us.
Being in the nation's capital, space is hard to come by. The men's lacrosse team, on the other hand, they're living lavish. Let's see how the fellas are living.
What's up, guys? James Carroll, number 66, Milton Mass.
What's up, guys? Ty Banks, number 17, Coquitlam, British Columbia. Welcome to our room. It's my side of the room. We got a little closet in here. You know, nothing
closet,
too...
look at this.
Yeah, nothing too crazy.
What's the date night? What's Ty rocking on date night? Mm. You mean tonight's...
Not a date night, but this is a fan favorite for sure. We got the Stewie Griffin jersey. People love that one.
He's the best dressed on the team.
John Dixon or JoJo Dean?
Who's the worst dressed?
Aiden Carello. Yes.
What is this?
Call of Duty Cold War. Boys are getting back into it. Just in a game, had to exit out a little early, but that's fine.
You're a big hat guy.
Yeah, I gotta give a shout out to the Coquitlam Madnax hometown box team.
Then we gotta pass it to your roommate. Yeah, your side, give us a walkthrough.
My side, so Ty's got the PS4. I've got the Xbox. Our favorite snack, Goldfish, sponsor match.
Yeah.
We just got this one, Step Brothers, yeah. Good movie.
Now you gotta be a student.
Yes.
Before you're an athlete.
We spend a lot of time on Calc. Yeah. Every night.
Calc's
every night.
Are you the smartest freshman?
No, I'm not.
Flat out, that was quick.
I'm not, no. It's definitely Anderson Moore.
Anderson Moore, really.
You have your closet. You have a little girlfriend?
I do.
Hey, what's her name? Do you want to give her a shout out?
No,
let's say you're taking a very fine young lady out on our date. What are you rocking?
Everything BCI. I'm going BCI sweatshirt.
BCI. High school guy. BCI Boston College High.
Helmet. I got BCI basketball.
Holy cow.
Wow.
I got more.
And we have a sink over here.
Sink.
What's sink used for?
Brush teeth 3 times a day, actually.
Then we got the two beds. We ever go like maybe feet here, head here,
no.
Head here, feet there?
I need to wake up every morning, see Ty, so that's what happens.
Hey, don't forget it.
BC High,
BC High.
Eagles.
Yes. Never close the yearbook.
Don't do it.
What's up? I'm Jack Leary, number 16 from Villanova, PA.
What's up? TJ Haley, number 4, Shadyside, Maryland.
Welcome to our Villa rooftop compound.
Yeah. We're in the living room right now. What are we usually watching on the 98 show right here?
I mean, it really depends. A lot of TV shows. We love BMS, you know, just keep it light, keep it loose after a hard day of practice and class.
Then we'll get the PlayStation going sometimes, a little FIFA, Madden.
We have two freshmen here. What are our thoughts on them early?
We love them. Great guys, yeah.
We got the kitchen behind us. Who's doing most of the cooking?
There's not really much cooking going on. The only person that's really doing anything is maybe TJ.
Yeah, I'll
really?
Do some cooking. Aiden Carroll also.
Here's the backpack rack right here. Who's this?
It's Will T.
We love pickleball.
Big pickleball. Who's the best pickleball player in the house?
I'd probably say myself.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah. This is Will T's and Aiden Carroll, two seniors. As you can tell, Will T, no light in here. He's got everything covered as much as possible.
Give us the background on this cat. Why is he like this?
I don't know. It's just, so whenever we have away games, I'm stuck with him, unfortunately.
Really?
And it's 8 o'clock and he's like, Lear's phone's got to go off. And he's just out. He gets up. If the temperature's just slightly off, he'll get up. He's got to readjust it. He just, everything needs to be in place with him. He is a weird cat for sure. But we all love him. This is our room right here. Jack Leary, TJ Haley place. We keep it neat for the most part. Both our sides, you know, we got some jerseys hanging up on that side. A couple Eagles. Bills, Phillies.
You're taking your girlfriend out on a nice date. You're trying to find a nice date.
Yeah.
Give us the outfit.
Faherty, some green pants. State and Liberty.
State and Liberty.
Super nice. Very athletic fit. You gotta love it.
I usually go with...
Somebody said you're the best dressed guy on the team.
I try and be. I got a pair of khakis in here somewhere. Maybe I'm washing them. And then for shirts-wise, maybe I'll go long sleeve here. Johnny O.
Two-tone Johnny O. Carolina blue. We got the brown.
And then I do love my polos. I will say that.
Look at this. I mean, that collar is looking really good. That's why they call you the best dressed.
Yes.
Best dressed. Coach.
It's got to be Coach Hogan, right?
Coach Warren Love, he loves his Air Forces, that's for sure, or Jordans. But I'd probably, honestly, Coach Shriver, he usually dabbles up pretty well.
Biggest pet peeve about this cat?
It's just dirty. I mean, yes.
A little bit.
Everything
he plays has to be at max volume. I'll be in bed trying to read or do something
TikTok
else.
Guy,
TikTok max volume.
I hate those guys, to be honest. I hate those guys. Time's all said and done, how do you want to be remembered?
A guy that hopefully guys want to call and, you know, say hello to and remember the good times and pick up a conversation like we're in this office. I think as a coach, that's a goal, is when you have your guys here and you have them for the 4 years that you're here, when you have that truthful, you have that great relationship. We base our program on relationships, so I want those guys to know that I'm always here for them, you know, and all I can do is just help them with my experiences. I don't have all the answers, but I think I can learn from experiences, and hopefully that opens their eyes or helps them in some sort of way.
A program that hasn't been to championship weekend since 1999. Can the Hoyas get back in 2024?
Is that a goal? Sure.
I think you can count on it.
I mean, you have to believe it, yeah.
I'd like to think so.
Yes. I'll do my best to be there, and I think our team is in the same mindset, so.
That's the goal every year. You know, I think this year, that I don't know when. I do and have a belief in my heart that we will do that at some point here in the future. I do think that we are building to that moment, and that's the goal. And, you know, again, if we can continue to, you know, win the Big East and give ourselves a chance to get in the NCAA tournament and roll the dice from there, I think, you know, the more and more chances we get at it, I think we certainly can get there, absolutely.
You know, it's a younger group, but I think it's a good thing for this team, for this program. Really just focus on development, and then, you know, it's an unselfish group. No one's caring about who's scoring. I think we can just take it day by day, win the Big East, and then kind of let the chips fall.
Yes, I do believe so. I think this year, with the guys that we have the talent. We obviously have an incredible coaching staff, and I think we're just an incredibly tight knit close group where everyone understands their role, understands what's expected of them from the top to the bottom, and I think that's going to allow us to really make the plays deep into May that we need to make that happen.
Obviously, that's a very, very challenging task year in and year out, and that's our goal. Our goal, win the Big East, get to the playoffs, get to championship weekend. That's the expectation I think that we have here at Georgetown, but we know it's a really tough task ahead.
It's been the goal since I got here. I know everyone committed to Georgetown with that in mind, so yeah.
I've been very fortunate enough to be there. It's really tough. A lot of things got to break your way. You got to be kind of lucky, and you got to be consistent. We'll figure it out, and that's probably a better question at the end of the season.
Georgetown staple, like staff coffee.
After every Tuesday, yes, Thursday morning.
Really?
Yes.
Lots of cinnamon today.
Yeah.
Lots of cinnamon.
I meant to give a dash, and it was more of a dunk of cinnamon and three Splendids. So I should be flying off the walls in about 20 minutes.